Hi students, the next one is acidic nature of phenols. Here yesterday we saw the acidic nature of alcohols. When we are telling about the alcohols, alcohols dissociate to give RCH2O minus and H plus. Here alcohol forming alkoxide ion. This is called as alkoxide ion. Alkoxide ion is formed and this is a proton is donated. So alcohols gives alkoxide ion, whereas if we are taking phenols, so when phenols are taken, what happens? Suppose if you are taking a phenol, here this is the phenol, then here it is a dissociating to form O minus and here H plus is formed. So phenol dissociate to give phenoxide ion. Here this is giving phenoxide ion. This is called as phenoxide ion. Phenoxide ion and proton is formed. And in this, first of all, tell me, alcohols are more acidic or phenols are more acidic? That is first question. In this alcohols and phenols, which is more acidic? As I gave already in the order of acidic nature of different compounds, phenols are given more acidic than alcohols. Here, phenols are more acidic than alcohols. Why? And for this, I gave the Ka value. Ka is equal to 10 power minus 16. And here for this, Ka is equal to 10 power minus 10. So, 10 power minus 10 value. Sorry, 10 power 16. And this is 10 power. And this is 10 power minus 10. And then here, this is the Ka values. So, basing on the Ka value also, we can say simply, this phenoxide ion proton production or the dissociation of phenol is easier than alcohol. And the second way we can say here, first one is basing on the Ka values, we can say alcohols are less acidic and phenols are more acidic. Second one is basing on the stability. Basing on the stability of ion formed. Here, this is alkoxide ion, this is phenoxide ion. Here, if you are taking the alkoxide ion, it is RCH2O minus. Whereas phenoxide ion, if you are taking, this is a wow minus and double bond is present. Here, there is a lone pair on the oxygen. Here also, there is a lone pair on the oxygen. Here this group is what type of group? We already said that this group is a plus I group. Alkyl group is a plus I group. And phenyl group, if you are taking, this is having sp2 carbon atom. This carbon atom is sp2 carbon atom. Whenever sp2 carbon atom is present, that is more electronegative. This is more electronegative carbon atom. Here this is sp3 carbon atom. sp3 carbon atom means this is a less electronegative. When compared with sp2, this is less electronegative. Whenever the anion is present on the less electronegative carbon atom and the anion is present on the more electronegative carbon atom, then here it is a donating group and here this is like a withdrawing group. Okay, so here phenoxide ion becomes more stable because of the electron disbursement. And third important reason is resonance. Third one and very, very important reason for why phenols are more acidic than alcohols. Phenoxide ion is a resonance stabilized. Phenoxide ion is resonance stabilized. Phenoxide. So, please remember, phenoxide ion is resonance stabilized. So, it is a resonance stabilized species. It is a resonance stabilized species, whereas alkoxide is not having any resonance because here it is having alkyl group only and this is a lone pair pi bond conjugation is present. Here it is having lone pair pi bond conjugation. So because of this lone pair pi bond conjugation, phenols are having resonance, whereas alkyl alkoxide if you are taking, there is no such type of resonance. So conjugation is not present. So there is no resonance in between these two. So phenoxide ion is resonance stabilized, whereas alkoxide ion is not stabilized. So phenols gives a more stable phenoxide ion by the release of a proton, whereas alcohol gives a less stable alkoxide ion by the release of proton. We will see the resonance structures of a phenoxide ion also. This is the phenoxide ion. This phenoxide ion resonance structures we will see. And here if you see that oxygen atom is having a lone pair of electrons. This lone pair is shifting onto this bond. Then this pi bond electron shifts onto the adjacent one. So it gives the resonance structure, the first resonance structure. Here it is a double bond O, and now it has two lone pairs only. Okay, and here this is getting the negative charge, and here it is pi bond, pi bond. And now this pair of electrons, negative charge means one lone pair shifts, and next pi bond shifted into that set. And then it is giving here a double bond, oxygen, two lone pairs, and here a pi bond. Here the negative charge you will get, and here pi bond is present. Again, this negative charge electron shifts, and this pi bond electrons are shifting onto the adjacent carbon. Then we will get a double bond O and two lone pairs, and here it is a negative charge, and here pi bond, pi bond. And again this pi bond negative charge is shift onto the adjacent bond. These pi bond electron shifts to give the beginning structure of the first structure. And here this is O minus, and it is having three lone pairs, pi bond, pi bond, pi bond. And these are called as the resonance structures of phenoxide ion. And the resonance structures of phenoxide ion, if you see, here we are getting negative charge at ortho position. Here, negative charge at ortho position. Here, negative charge at para position. And here also again, negative charge at ortho position. And there is no negative charge at meta position. That is also you please remember. So phenoxide ion, if you are taking, the phenoxide ion has electron density at ortho and para positions. Okay, these are the resonance structures of phenoxide ion. More electron density, here negative charge means it has one lone pair. This negative charge is more, or electron density is more at ortho and para position. Because of more electron density at ortho and para position, what happens? The less electron density is present at meta positions. The meta positions are having less electron density. Okay. And there is one more comparison. Resonance structures of a phenol. Here, resonance structures of a phenol when we are taking. The phenol and phenoxide ion resonance structures I am comparing. Here phenol resonance structures means this is the phenol molecule. Here this is the phenol OH. It is having two lone pairs. Even phenol is also having resonance because of this. This pair of electrons are shifting. This lone pair electrons are in conjugation. So this pi bond electron shifts. So what happens here? Because of the lone pair shifted from the oxygen, oxygen now has one lone pair only, and so it gets a positive charge. And here it is getting negative charge. And this is pi bond. And here this is getting the shift of electrons, and this is again getting shifted. So we will get the same O, and here it is having positive charge and H. And here it is pi bond, and here negative charge and pi bond. Again, this pi bond electrons are shifting. Okay, so this pi bond electron shifts, and here, so double bond OH plus, and here negative charge and pi bond, pi bond. And again, if this pair of electrons are shifting, then this pair of electrons shifts onto the oxygen. So we will get OH again with two lone pairs, and pi bond, pi bond, pi bond. See, what is the difference between phenol and phenoxide and resonance structures? Which is more stable? So if they are asking, sometimes they may ask phenol and phenoxide and we are taking which is more stable and why. Here, phenol, phenoxide ion if we are taking, here this is having positive charge and negative charge. Means in phenol resonance structures, we are having charge separation. Charge separation is present. Charge separation is present. First and important point to remember. Here, no charge separation. We have only negative charge on the benzene ring at ortho and para positions. Okay. Or on the phenoxide ion only. Okay. But here we are having charge separation. And second important point to remember, in phenol resonance structures, oxygen is having positive charge. Oxygen means it is more electronegative. More electronegative oxygen atom. More electronegative oxygen atom has positive charge. Generally, in resonance structures, what we will say, the positive charge present on less electronegative atoms. Positive charge present on less electronegative atoms are always more stable. But here, how they present positive charge on more electronegative atom. So, when phenol and phenoxide ion resonance structures are compared, always remember, phenoxide ion resonance structures. Phenoxide ion resonance structures are more stable than phenol resonance structures. Okay, the resonance stability due to phenoxide ion and phenol, if you take, phenoxide ion is getting more stability because it is getting more stable resonance structures. Okay, and this is also comparison. Sometimes they may ask, and main thing is here charge separation is present and more electronegative oxygen atom has positive charge. That is the drawback of this phenol resonance structures. And even here also phenol, if you see, where is the electron density at ortho position? Here it is at ortho position. And here also this is at para position. In this electron density is more at para position. And here the electron density is more at ortho position. So, at ortho position only the electron density increases because of OH group or because of O minus group. So, whenever there is an electrophile attack occurring, they will be always at ortho position and para position. And moreover, O minus is a plus I group and plus M group. It is very important because of plus I plus M effect, ortho position is more favorable for this, and sometimes para position also, we will discuss something later about this. Okay, and phenol if you are taking, that is different. Okay, so this is phenol and phenoxide ion resonance structures. Okay, please remember this. So, acidic nature of phenols and alcohols, when you compare, phenols are always more acidic than alcohols because phenol forms phenoxide ion on dissociation, which is stabilized by resonance. Whereas alcohol is not forming such type of resonance stabilized alkoxide ion. Okay. And next, whenever there is any substitution, means substituted phenols acidic nature, substituted phenols means there may be ortho position or there may be para position or there may be meta position substituted by other groups. If they are substituted, then how the acidic nature will be there? Maybe substituted, if you are having, there is a minus I group and minus M groups. Generally, if minus I minus M groups are present yet ortho and para positions, generally remember ortho and para positions, then they increase the acidic nature. Ortho and para positions increases acidic nature, increases acidic nature of phenols. Okay, generally minus I minus M groups at ortho and para positions if present, they increases the acidic nature. I am giving example for the minus I minus M group and O2 group. Okay, and CHO group we can write, we will use a letter. And second point, plus I plus M groups if present. When plus I plus M groups if present at ortho or para positions, at ortho and para positions, when they are at ortho and para position, they decrease. So here they decrease acidic nature. They decrease acidic nature of phenols. Okay. Please remember inductive effect. Very, very important thing. We generally forget about this. Inductive effect is distance dependent effect means when distance increases, inductive effect power decreases. Okay, when distance is increasing, so ortho, meta, para positions, if you are taking, suppose I am writing the phenol structure here, this is the phenol and the adjacent one is called as ortho position and this is called as meta position, this is called as para position. 1,2 ortho, 1,3 meta, 1,4 para. In this side also same ortho, meta, para. Okay, if ortho, meta positions are there, inductive effect, whatever it may be, either minus I or plus I, minus I or plus I, the minus I or plus I effect power, ortho is more than meta, meta is more than para. Ortho, meta, para positions, inductive effect power is always in this order. Please remember, it is very, very important. We think sometimes without considering this point, para position, minus I is there, sir, minus I is there, minus I is there. But minus I effect at para position is very less. But minus I effect at ortho position is very high. So please consider, it is a distance dependent effect. So when distance increases, the minus I or plus I power decreases. Okay. But mesomeric effect, the second point, mesomeric effect, if you are taking, mesomeric effect is same or no change at, mesomeric effect is same at ortho and para positions, at ortho is equal to para positions. There is no difference for mesomeric effect and no mesomeric effect, no plus M or minus M effect. Please remember this, no plus M or minus M effect, no plus M or minus M effect yet meta position. So meta position, you are not having any minus M or plus M effect. You see the phenol phenoxide resonance structures, electron density increases at ortho and para positions only. So mesomeric effect or resonance is only observed at ortho and para positions. So plus M or minus M, whatever it may be, it is present at ortho and para position and it is same at both ortho and para positions. And mesomeric effect is not observed at meta positions. If you are sometimes, if NOT is present at meta position, for example, NOT is present at this position. If you are writing here, sir, this is having minus M effect. It is a blunder mistake, completely wrong. Okay, never consider at meta position, never consider the minus M effect. What we can consider only? Minus I effect only. So at meta position means, whatever it may be the group, you consider only inductive effect. sometimes the group may be minus I, sometimes the group may be plus I. Means suppose if there is a methyl group, for example, if they are giving methyl group, the methyl group is having plus I effect. Okay, so the mesomeric effect and also hyperconjugation, we can say. Mesomeric effect and hyperconjugation effect is at ortho and para position. Inductive effect is present in ortho and meta and para position. It is depending upon the distance, and the distance increases, the inductive effect power decreases. Okay, you remember these things first when you are going for the acidic nature of substituted phenols. After remembering this only, we can do the acidic nature of substituted phenols. So see these four compounds, first four compounds, what is the acidic nature order? Here in this first one, if you are taking NO2 is pair, this is called as para-nitrophenol. This is known as para-nitrophenol. So para-nitrophenol, this is ortho-nitrophenol, this is meta-nitrophenol, it is only phenol. And in this, what is the substituted group present? NO2 group. What type of group is this one? NO2 group is called as minus M effect group, minus I effect group. Minus M, minus I effect groups, what they can do? They increase the acidic nature of phenols. We already said minus I, minus M groups increase the acidic nature of alcohols and phenols. Plus M, plus I groups decrease the acidic nature of alcohols and phenols. Okay, so here, whenever there is a para-nitrophenol and ortho-nitrophenol, here what is the effects present? I am writing simply, here para-nitrophenol is having two effects. One is a minus M effect. Because of minus M effect, what happens? The acidic nature increases. And here second one, what is present is minus I effect. So because of minus I effect also, the acidic nature increases. Next, here NO2, if you are taking it ortho position, minus M effect is present here, there is no change and it increases gradually. And here also we have minus I. Minus I here it is less, or it is minimum. Minus I here it is minimum. Okay, whatever it may be, increases. Here minus I effect is maximum. Whenever minus I effect is maximum, this has more acidic nature than this one now. Generally, minus M is same. Here and here, both are same. But minus I is a maximum here. Minus I is minimum here. Then, minus I maximum means it increases largely. And so, acidic nature is more now. Why ortho-nitrophenol has less acidic nature than para-nitrophenol? The reason is, here it is forming a hydrogen bond. It is forming a hydrogen bond because of the intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Due to the formation of intramolecular hydrogen bond, this proton cannot be removed easily. So, this is having less acidic nature. The ortho-nitrophenol is having less acidic nature than para-nitrophenol. Okay. In third place, what is present? Here, minus M present. Minus M is absent. Don't write meta position minus M. Okay, what is present here? Minus I only. Minus I only. Even though it increases the acidic nature. So, it has a next more acidic nature. And then last one is phenol. Any groups are not present. So, that is the least acidic compared with these three. So, please remember, in para-nitrophenol, ortho-nitrophenol, which is more acidic means para-nitrophenol is more acidic than ortho-nitrophenol. Okay. Next, in these four compounds, if you see, what is present? Here phenol, here it is only methyl group, methyl group, methyl group. Meta, para, ortho. This is also called as metacrisol. This is commonly called as crisols. These are commonly called as crisols. This is metacrisol. I am writing it is metacrisol. It is paracrisol. This is orthocrisol. And what type of group is this CH3 group? CH3 group is a plus HC group, not plus M group. Mesomeric effect not shown by the methyl group. It shows plus HC. What is HC? HC means hyperconjugation. And the second is plus I group. plus HCr plus I if present, what they can do? They decrease the acidic nature. Okay. When compared without that group, is better than having that group. So, phenol is more acidic. Phenol is more acidic than any other chrysals. Because the methyl group will decrease the acidic nature. Whatever may be the place it present, it decreases the acidic nature. So, phenol is more acidic than the other three. In this three, which is better one? Here it is having what type of effect? It is having plus I only. Please remember, it has plus I only. When plus I only present, it decreases. Even plus I, it is decreasing acidic nature. Here, what type of effect is present? Plus M is present, which decreases the acidic nature. And plus I is present, which also the plus I is minimum. Plus I is minimum at para position, distance dependent, I tell na. I said this. So, this is decreasing. And here this is also decreasing. Okay. And here what is present? Plus HC. Sorry. I wrote plus M. This is sometimes we can call it as plus M, but it is plus HC. And here it is called as plus HC. And this is also having plus I. Plus I maximum. So plus HC plus I if you are taking, both are decreasing the acidic nature. So, here only we have plus I effect. The power of plus I effect is less than hyperconjugation. Now, what is the order of power? Mesomeric effect is always greater than hyperconjugation, is greater than inductive effect. It is in given in the first year. You please check the first year. Okay. So, here in this hyperconjugation and mesomeric induct effect, if you compare, induct effect is less. And it is at metaposition, so this is better or more acidic compared with the para. Why para and ortho para is more acidic? In this para, induct effect is minimum. Here, induct effect is maximum. So, this is more acidic than ortho chrysal. And next, third one. Here, this is metamethoxyphenol. Metamethoxyphenol. And this is only phenol. It is orthomethoxyphenol. It is paramethoxyphenol. Here, what type of group is this? OCH3 group, if you are taking, it is having plus M effect and minus I effect. So, OCH3 is a plus M effect and minus I effect group. Plus M effect means it decreases the acidic nature. Minus I effect means it increases the acidic nature. So, two are there. One is decreasing, another one is increasing. Now, we will check the acidic nature. Here in metaposition, what effects are present? At metaposition, we said only induct effect. So, what is present here? Minus I effect only present. Minus I effect, what they can do? They increase the acidic nature. And here phenol, no group is present. Here ortho. Ortho means what are present? Plus M effect is present, which decreases the acidic nature. Minus I effect is present, that is maximum. Minus effect is maximum. And this minus effect increases the acidic nature. And here plus M effect is present, which decreases the acidic nature. Minus I effect is present, but the minus I effect is minimum. Okay, it decreases. So, here only minus I effect is present. So, this is the most acidic. Next is only phenol. And next here, plus M effect is powerful than minus I effect. And in this minus I, which is more? This one. So, orthomethoxy and next is paramethoxy. Okay, please note down that. See in these compounds, here X means it is a halogen, ortho halophenol, para, meta halophenol, para halophenol. Halogens are chlorine, bromine, iodine is taken. And here halogen means it is having minus I, maximum, and minus I group increases. here minus I only present and minus I group increases. Here minus I is minimum, para position. So minus I is minimum, anyhow it increases. So minus I maximum means more acidic, next minus I and minus I minimum. That is the acidic nature order. And here we are having five different compounds. One is having O minus, another one is having CH3 group. This is called as CH3 group. It is a methyl group. And this is only phenol, this is chlorophenol, this is nitrophenol. And in this, if you see, O minus means it is a plus M effect group. And this is a plus HC effect group. And there is no groups. Here it is a minus I effect group. And this is a minus M effect group. So the acidic nature increases gradually. Okay. This is the order of acidic natures in substituted phenols.